Some people got big brains, some people don't. The fact that my grammar just now was pretty poor puts me in a position where you're gonna question whether mine is. But what I do know is that whether my brain is big or small, ClickUp Brain is a new product subset of ClickUp that is launched recently, and it's one of those AI sort of things. You know, every product's got AI, you know, Evernote, Notion, your aunt down the street invented an AI about something, and then she realizes it was just Gemini on Googling stuff, and then you have to talk to her about it. It's a whole thing. But what I do know, once again, is the fact that this ClickUp update has been intriguing, but I haven't mentioned it on my channel. So in this video, we're going to dive into ClickUp Brain and talk about it in comparison to Notion, as I feel like a lot of these products are similar, and you're probably wondering the exact same thing. Let's get right into it. So first and foremost, just upon a Google search, they're back at it with the hilariously over-the-top jargon and branding. One AI to replace them all. That's so cool, ClickUp. You're so edgy. First of all, product itself has some interesting capabilities. Seems very similar to Notion, Q&A, and AI. However, pretty much everything is a task in ClickUp, so I'm sure that its capabilities are actually probably a bit better when it comes to referencing the data inside of it. But you'll see that the AI writer can do a myriad of things. It can be a writing assistant, it's built in spell check, it has AI quick replies, it can create tables, templates, and transcripts. Transcripts is definitely something Notion can't do. Templates is something that I would say it can't as well, but I'm sure it'll get there. And you'll notice that for AI, it's actually $5 per month, whereas Notion AI, from a pricing standpoint, is actually a little bit more. Notion AI is $8 per member per month if you bill annually, and $10 for monthly. So I'm pretty surprised that ClickUp's cheaper on this, but I guess they gotta make revenue somewhere with Notion. Notion doesn't have the same type of market that, you know, ClickUp's targeting. It's more enterprise customers, that sort of thing. So they're gonna make more money on the base product, so the upsells don't need to be as high probably. Subtask generation, as you can tell, is a pretty key indicator that this AI workflow is going to work with like their databases per se a little bit better than Notion's does. Notion's database and AI don't really connect very well. Voice and video transcription is actually really surprising. I have no idea how they actually built that into this, so I'm just excited to check it out. What's interesting is you can try this for free with like a demo sort of thing. So if I click on this link on this site and I go into my account, you'll be like, oh, hey, you wanna upgrade and buy, or do you wanna try ClickUp AI for free? Okay, cool. So ClickUp AI allows you to do a fair amount of things. So for example, let's ask about docs in your workspace based on your role. Okay, that's actually very interesting. So ask about your tasks. What tasks are created by me and closed? And you can see this is actually referencing like database data rather than just like pages. And I'd say this is pretty solid because this is hyperlinking these different pages, right? Or I guess tasks. So if I click on this with a middle click, it sends me here. And that's pretty impressive. Just the fact that it references different tasks and they're hyperlinked, pretty cool. I can press ask AI about this task and say, find similar tasks, for example. So it seems like there's no similar tasks, which is fair. Ask about this task to give more context, I guess, as a option here. So just the ability to ask AI for something like this is pretty intriguing. And you can ask any specific thing. If you don't want to just look at the due date, you can ask when the deadline is. But I'm going to test it with something like that. Okay. So for example, I want to know there's no one who's responsible. So I'm actually curious if we can figure out if there's no responsible party here. Okay. It's telling me how it's going to do it. So I created the task, own the task, likely responsible for overseeing. Interesting. So it knows that there's no context for the assigned field, but it knows that I made it. And I think it knows who created the template in the first place. Whoever provided this image in the template. So this is great for context, I think, because if you don't know who created it, that sort of thing. Yeah, wow, okay. And you can also write a summary here with AI pretty immediately since they have a description section. Wow, so interesting. So you can add some talking points here about this. Let's talk about what is this task. I just want to know what the task is. It's kind of just a very basic overview. Please provide the context or details of the task. This is a task about going to the store to buy workout clothes for a 5k I'm running in a few weeks. Intriguing. It's giving me a lot here. Okay, let's just insert this so you can check it out. So you know, you can regenerate, copy, or edit it. But if I press insert, wow, it's gonna make me a description. Press show more. You can full page this, and all of this description stuff does work with markdown functionality. and their backslash stuff. Wow. So shopping for 5K run, objective purchase clothes for a 5K run the next few weeks before race day, moisture wicking running shirt. Heck yeah. Breathable running shorts or leggings. Heck yeah. I love me some short shorts. Supportive running shoes. Yeah. Duh. Okay. All of this is actually some nice extra context for what a task could look like for going to the store to buy running clothes. So actually really nice here. I'm noticing overall with this AI, it has the overall capability of pressing this and it kind of turns into your co-pilot. You'll see that there is a keyboard shortcut. So I guess if I press option K, it opens it up. Pretty cool. I don't notice it in like the bottom right where a lot of different ones are like Notion. But if I press ask AI, I feel like this is pretty great. Like what are the custom fields included in the getting started document? Yeah, this can reference the databases, I'm gonna call them, and Notion just can't. So if I go back to here, right? And if I go to the use frame for social posts, like I have to make a new automation update here. So if I do slash AI, right? And I just do summarize, it'll summarize the page itself, right? Like there's a lot of different text here and that's cool. The document outlines the process for managing social posts using the frame process. It includes steps for uploading content, handling, changing labels and cleaning. So that's cool. That's cute. Like I can do that. But what about this? What if I go to the bottom right and say, you know, I know it's still in beta, obviously. What is the due date for this page? Like I'm on a page right now. You think it'd be able to reference this? Yeah, no, it completely just goes to, random. I don't know how I can't reference the page I'm in. I think that's a little frustrating. I'm glad that it like kind of keeps your queries, that sort of thing. But this is like strictly based on the text is what I'm trying to get across. You can't really reference if you have a task database, that sort of thing. So if you're really trying to do a project management, you know, improvement with AI, and you're trying to utilize a product like this, you're spending way more for worse functionality from a project management AI standpoint. Where we go back here to ClickUp Brain, for example, I can say something like create 5 tasks in the getting things done database for a series of tasks on how to run a good 5K. I don't know. Something to that effect. You'll notice it referenced the buy workout clothes. It referenced that. Now, if I press create here and I can do task or document, I can then put it into whatever database I want, right? Like my daily tasks is obviously fine. And I'd put a task name for here. So this is just like a sequence of different tasks here. So complete 5K plan, create task or create and start another, or create and duplicate, press create task. And then within here, I go to it and you'll notice that it's got it all set up for me. And if I go to subtasks here, I can suggest subtasks. And you'll notice if I press create subtasks, it ends up making them based off of these 5, which just to be clear, there is no world in where Notion is even close to this from a task management standpoint. So augmenting your task management workflow with ClickUp loads better, not even close. It's laughably off in comparison. So that's why I wanted to show the difference. One is great for like text-based stuff, referencing things. It's in beta, that's cute. Releasing a product and putting in beta for months and then acting like you get the excuse of it being in beta. So like, oh, I'm so sorry. Like, no, like just, I don't know, multi-billion dollar company. Other companies are doing better. I think both are fine, but I wanted to make this clear. Task management, project management, ClickUp, note-taking, text-based references, Notion. Let me know your thoughts on this, and let me know your thoughts on this video on how to improve your skills using tools like ClickUp and Notion even more.